As guitar players, one of the key ingredients that we look for in a distortion or overdrive sound is a pedal that can simulate the sound of an overdriven amp, a tube amp that is being kind of driven right to its max and gives this beautiful distortion and overdriven tone. However, most pedals maybe only emulate this to a certain degree. But those that really stand out are those that create a very natural tube-like distortion and overdrive sound that you can manipulate by way of your volume control on your guitar. When you bring the volume control back, you get kind of a cleaner, chimier sound. And as you roll up the volume on your guitar, you get a much more overdriven and distorted sound, and it varies as you do different shades of volume. And today, what our video is all about is highlighting what I consider to be the five most dynamic overdrive, distortion, and fuzz pedals that are available, and the ones that I really think most closely emulate what happens when you have a heavily overdriven amplifier on the edge of breakup, and you're able to pull it back just by the way of using volume knob on your guitar. Now, before we get into these pedals today that I'm going to highlight that really simulate the sound of an overdriven amplifier very naturally and accurately, I want to encourage you to subscribe. Only about 20% of you viewing any of our videos in any given week are actual subscribers, and I suspect a lot of you actually believe that you're subscribed but are actually not. So I welcome you to check, ensure that you are subscribed. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe, hit the bell icon so that you can stay up to date with all the videos that we're putting out every single week. So now let's get back to these pedals. So today I'm going to highlight five different pedals, and they're from several different generations of guitar pedals, some as early as 1960, and some more recent as of popular pedals that are around today. I'll mention also some alternatives if there is something that's rare or vintage or unusual so that you can check out maybe some other alternatives should they exist for a lot of these different devices. So before we get into the samples and discussion of these pedals today, I just want to talk about signal path very quickly. I have a PRS 513. I'm going to be using a combination of single coil and humbucking pickups from the guitar today. I also am going to be running into the various pedals that we're going to be using as our exemplars of dynamic overdrive and distortion pedals. Those are then going to be feeding into the front of the clean channel of a Soldano SLO. If you're familiar with this clean channel, you know it is very scooped, doesn't have a lot of mid-range, and isn't particularly characteristic of any particular amp. It's a pretty neutral platform. Also, I'm running wet, dry, wet using the line out of the back of the Soldano SLO. That's feeding a J Rocket Clockwork delay, feeding a Wazacraft version of a Boss Dimension C, and then that's feeding a Hardwire RV7 for reverb set to a plate reverb. For the most part, those will all be on in subtle settings. The delay will be adjusted to time based on the actual part that I'm going to be playing for each of these examples. And the speaker that the amp is going through is a Vintage 30 mic'd with an SM7B. The stereo wet effects are feeding into a GFI Cab Zeus as a simulated power amp and speaker cab, and that's also set to a Vintage 30 but mic'd with an SM57 on each side of the wet effects. So first, let's talk about the Roger Mayer Voodoo 1. Now, Roger Mayer, as many people know, was the tech for Jimi Hendrix, and a lot of his pedals are inspired by some of the sounds and tones of Jimi Hendrix. Now, I don't know exactly what the marketing was behind the Voodoo 1, but I know the pedigree of players that have used this pedal subsequently since Jimi Hendrix passed away, two of which are Scott Henderson and Michael Landau, who absolutely make this pedal sing. It's very dynamic, it cleans up great with the volume control, and it really makes a stratty kind of single coil sound sound so much throatier and really bell-like, the way that a lot of us have come to understand the Jimi Hendrix tone, especially kind of his edge of breakup tones that are not quite getting into fuzz. So I'm going to play a little piece that's reminiscent of a Michael Landau tune, and I'm going to show what this does. I'm going to start with kind of my volume control in the middle, and then I'm going to kind of bring it up in the middle of the song so you can kind of hear how dynamically everything kind of shifts, and the distortion and overdrive that it creates is very beautiful, but also sounds great when you have the guitar volume rolled down. Let's check out the Voodoo One by Roger Mayer. Absolute amazing pedal. So that was the Roger Mayer Voodoo One. Again, very dynamic, very amp-like. I just love, again, what it does to single coil guitars. Just makes them bloom in a way that is not possible really with any other pedal, in my opinion. For the second pedal today, we're going to be using the Vertex, my company, Tone Secret. And the Tone Secret is kind of a unique pedal that never really took off for us, but I always thought it was one of our most natural and dynamic sounding overdrives. It kind of mixed some elements of a tube screamer and also had some elements of kind of the preamp section of a mid-60s kind of black panel Fender. But it was done in such a way that it was all solid state. There is no tube in this, of course. But these really do sound great, whether you're playing with single coils or whether you're playing with humbucking pickups. And for this example, I'm going to go to some humbucking pickups inside the 513. I'm going to kind of do like a little Tom Petty-ish sort of thing and kind of just hold some of these notes and sustain them. And they really just bloom in such a unique way. Where sometimes, depending on how you have this set, it can almost get kind of more of a tweed style kind of overdrive or distortion. And then when you clean it up, it just has a beautiful chime to it. It doesn't necessarily sound too tube screamery, but really has a unique sound of its own. And I've never really found anything that I thought sounded exactly like this. And in fact, right now, these are an absolute steal. You can get these from Sweetwater for $99.99. These are incredibly well made, have the same lifetime warranty of any of our other products. And I think you're going to see here that it really does sound fantastic. So let's check out the Tone Secret, play a little bit. I'm going to start with the volume roll down on the guitar, and then as I go for some solo notes, I'm going to bring up that volume so you can really hear those notes bloom and really stand out. So that was the Tone Secret, again, a pedal for us that I've always really loved and I thought sounded very dynamic and natural, and you could really kind of hear what it was doing there in the context of that little sample. And again, absolute steal, $99, can't go wrong. Definitely go check that out at Sweetwater if you're interested in getting one of these. They sound amazing. I think you're going to be really happy with it if you want something that's really dynamic and also great value. Now I want to move on to the Chula by Love Pedal. And really, I think when I'm saying Chula, I could just as well be talking about a pedal called the COT 50 or the COT 50, the Church of Tone, made by Love Pedal. These are basically two COT 50s in one. The only difference between this and the COT 50 is you have two channels, and one of them has a pot for the amount of gain or volume, and then the other one is just fixed in its position. Now, I'm going to be using this to show just some really dynamic, kind of overdriven, amp-like tones. You're going to hear me start with the volume a little more brought back, and then I'm going to kind of dial it in when I go for some single notes. And you're just going to hear the bloom and dynamic nature of this. And it sounds so early generation Marshalls to me when I hear kind of like the breakup and doing some double stops and doing a little bit of just kind of like chording and then moving into single notes. It behaves that way too under the fingers. And I think that that's the real thing about the chula is the feel is really incredible, and that's why guys like Josh Smith use this effect because it just sounds so great, sounds so natural, and the overdrive is really unmatched by really anything else. It's got its own unique flavor that really nothing else does. So let's check out the chula. So that was the chula, really, really great stuff there. And it was very inspiring to play. I was kind of doing a little Fleetwood Mac, kind of Lindsey Buckingham thing. And I just felt like, man, it's so inspiring under the fingers. It really feels great, very touch sensitive. And whatever you're doing with your right and left hand is expressed perfectly through that pedal. Let's now move to the Boss OD-1. Now, this is a overdrive that has been out since the 80s. It is a classic overdrive sound, and I think a lot of people maybe unfairly relegate this into a Tube Screamery sort of comparison. I don't find it to sound like a Tube Screamer whatsoever. It sounds much more open and dynamic to me. It actually sounds really representative of 80s rock tones. And in keeping with that and the popularity of the resurgence of Top Gun, I'm going to kind of do a little kind of tribute to the original kind of Steve Stevens theme song for Top Gun. And use this to kind of get some nice gain. I'm just going to try a few chords just to start it off and just have the volume rolled down. And then I'm going to roll it up and get into some single notes. And it really sounds incredible. It has a really nice bloom, a really beautiful compression. And sometimes when you get a little too much compression, it tends to suffer on the cleanup. But I don't find that at all with this particular pedal. It's very dynamic all the way throughout. And can give you some really great 80s tones. You back it off, you have some nice, chimey, beautiful, clean tones. Let's check it out. So the OD-1, again, a classic, very, very revered amongst Boss pedal fans, a great overdrive, and really has its own character, very 80s, I think, in its orientation, but equally dynamic to anything else that we use today. And for our final, fifth, most dynamic pedal, I chose the Fuzz Face. Now, a lot of different fuzzes could have fit the bill for this. I chose the Fuzz Face because of the pedigree of players that chose this as part of their iconic sounds, players like Jimi Hendrix. And this is an original 1970 Silicon Fuzz Face. So I'm going to play a little bit kind of outside woman blues-ish sort of sound, kind of like what you would have heard from Cream era Eric Clapton. Of course, nowhere as good as Eric Clapton. But I'm going to do a little something around that. I'm going to start just with the guitar rolled down and kind of just play that opening riff. And then I'm going to bring in the fuzz by way of bringing up the volume control. The fuzz will be on the whole time, but you're going to see how clean it gets when the guitar is rolled down and then how dirty it gets when you bring that volume up and the fuzz is engaged. It just sounds absolutely terrifyingly distorted. And that's just quintessential fuzz face. If you just move the volume control on your guitar a few notches down, you have perfectly pristine clean. You bring it up and you have a fire-breathing monster. So let's hear how this thing sounds. I've got pretty much the volume almost at max, the fuzz almost at max, and I feel like that's kind of the sweet spot for this particular fuzz. So let's hear it, see how it sounds, doing a little bit of a kind of a Clapton-esque kind of outside woman blues. Mm-hmm. So that was the fuzz face, absolutely insanely distorted. I think that this one tends to maybe be a little fartier than some of the other fuzz faces that are out there. Again, every one was kind of different. None of the parts were really sorted or matched. And so you get a huge variety in different sounds of fuzz faces. I kind of like that sound, though, to kind of being a little bit more farty and distorted. It's kind of a cool thing for me, and it's very unique at what it does. And just the fact that it's a 1970-ish vintage original makes me like it even more. But of course, there again are other fuzz faces that are absolutely wonderful. Even newer versions by people like Analog Man and Dunlop can also be really, really great. So we heard several pedals today, very dynamic pedals throughout. We saw the Roger Mayer Voodoo 1. It's kind of a unique thing. I actually don't really know of anybody else that's making anything that resembles the Voodoo 1. And I think Roger Mayer still makes it, not exactly in that exact formation, but there are versions of it available. With the Tone Secret from us, I guess you could get a Tube Screamer and get some sort of kind of, you know, black panel Fender sort of preamp and put them together and get something that's kind of close to it, but certainly not for $99. That's a pedal with a lifetime warranty that is American made. You're probably not going to get that for $99, but you know, if you have those pedals already and you want to put them together, I highly recommend you try it. And if you just want to spend $99 and get a Tube Screamer from Sweetwater, I think you're going to be really happy with the result and how great this sounds and how dynamic it interacts with your guitar and amp. Now with the Chula from Love Pedal, it's kind of a unique piece. You can really only get those from Love Pedal. Of course, the COT 50 is another alternative. They also have a miniature version, I think, called the Amp 50. Those are also really great and can get you kind of in the zone there. They will be significantly less expensive than an original COT 50 or an original Chula. I believe the one I have here is a reissue version, and I think that Love Pedal does still make them, so I would definitely check on their website to see what's available. As far as the Boss OD-1, I'm not sure that Boss has actually reissued it. Maybe they have and I just didn't hear about it. And I don't really know of anybody who's specifically making that pedal. I'm sure that some of you watching this will have some good alternatives. So if you know of any, please do put those in the comments so that we can let other people know who's making an OD-1 replica. But to my knowledge, it's exclusively a Boss thing. And perhaps somebody else has remade it. I'm just not aware of who they are. And lastly, with the fuzz face, there are so many great manufacturers of fuzz face replicas. I think Analog Man is probably the high watermark for most people making fuzzes, but equally great budget fuzzes would be from MXR and Dunlop. They make wonderful stuff. I really love the Super Badass fuzz. It's really great. I don't know that it's necessarily based on a fuzz face, but it does sound wonderful. And of course, the mini fuzzes that Dunlop makes are really great and small and compact. And they also have some of those full-size fuzzes that have maybe artist tribute versions like Hendrix or Joe Bonamassa or players like Eric Johnson. You can get all different variations of those types of artist signature versions of the fuzz. And they all sound absolutely great, and they're really wonderful. And Dunlop does a really good job of making sure that those are tight and tolerance and very consistent from unit to unit, unlike the vintage fuzz like I have. So if you enjoyed the video today, I highly recommend, again, you like, you subscribe, you leave us a comment, tell us some other pedals that you think fall into this category of ultra dynamic pedals. When you're moving around your volume control on your guitar, you get a totally different sound if you're full up on 10 versus on 1 and a lot of different tones in between. We would love to hear from you on that. And if you want to support us so that we can continue to make future videos like this, of course, you can buy one of our products. Again, we mentioned a really great one that's a great price right now with the Tone Secret at $99 over at Sweetwater. But another thing that you could do is, and it's totally free, is check out our podcast, Chairman of the Boards. Every week, I do a roundtable discussion with two other rig builders, Grant Klassen from Goodwood Audio and Brian O'Million from O'Million Audio. We talk about gear and tone and pedal boards and best practices, and it's a really interesting listen. It's about 1 hour, and every single week, we release one on Monday, so definitely do check that out. And if you're interested in any of the supplies that I use, like the cables that we use to plug into all the pedals and all the gear that we use to connect the signal from A to B, those are all available over at theriggdr.com, along with all sorts of pedal board essentials like zip ties, tie down mounts, Velcro. All of our approved stuff is available there as accessories, so definitely do check that out. And if you want to go even further and get some consultations with us, we offer that over on theriggdr.com as well, where you can get one-to-one coaching on your rig to help you troubleshoot or help you just plan out what's going to be next in terms of your pedal choice and your future pedal board. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this rundown of what I consider to be the 5 most dynamic pedals out there in the marketplace. I hope you check one of them out. Until next time, I'm Mason Marangella from Vertex Effects, aka The Rig Doctor. See you later.